everybody. So, MLB 15, the show, was released a few weeks ago, and I'm here to tell you whether or not it's worth your money. Here are my thoughts.
MLB 15, the show, the 10th entry in the long-running Sony San Diego baseball franchise, and the second to be released on the PlayStation 4, takes what worked in last year's edition, added some new features, fixed some technical issues that plagued last year's entry, added in some new ones, and updated the rosters. Essentially, it feels like most annual sports games that are released every year, but in the case of the show, that's not exactly a bad thing. One of the areas that the show has always excelled at is in its presentation. As cliche as it may sound, it really feels like you're playing a baseball game that you could watch on any given day. The logos, team introduction, highlights, and banners are all spot on, and while some diehard fans might notice some discrepancies between the game's rendering and its real-world counterpart, the attention to detail in the color of the grass, all the way down to the Under Armour that some of the players wear, is astounding. And you can really tell that Sony San Diego really wanted to make this as authentic as possible. Crowd models have been improved greatly from last year, with more variations in how they move, react, go up and down stairs, or get pumped during the postseason, and they'll cheer and sing along with every bit of music that blasts through the stadium speakers. It feels real, and while some models will do repeated actions over and over again, it's a noticeable difference from previous entries in the series, and something I greatly appreciated. One of the major improvements from last year's edition is in the improved lighting found throughout the game. Shadows move realistically as the game goes on, and depending on the month you play, the sun will go down slower or faster. And the improvements to the nighttime game are especially appreciated, since that's always one area the game has struggled with. The only area the game genuinely struggles with in regards to its presentation is in the commentary. If you're a newcomer to the series, you probably won't notice it as much at first, but a lot of lines have been repeated from last year's edition, and after a while, the same pre-recorded lines will start to pop up, especially if you favor one team over another. The actual game of baseball, though, is more or less unchanged from previous entries, and personally, I don't mind that all that much. It's still as realistic, strategic, and as hard-hitting as it's always been. But the improved frame rate, faster loading times, and a few new changes have made it definitely something worth checking out for longtime fans. The two biggest changes to the formula are directional hitting and the new ball pursuit logic utilized by the outfielders. Directional hitting allows you to push or pull the bat in a direction that you think will best work to the advantage of the batter, and you can better control whether you want the ball to pop up or stay on the ground depending on how you stand. It still all comes down to timing, and it's not something that's required while you're batting, but having the option there became something I really enjoyed, as it became a crucial part of my strategy in some of the closer games I played. The new ball pursuit logic allows outfielders to better position themselves when a ball is hit, and it gives it a much more dynamic and realistic feeling than it has in years past. The other modes featured in the game are largely unchanged from previous years, though there have been a few new additions here or there to keep it feeling slightly fresh. Franchise mode now has sponsorships, which can raise the team budget, a radio program updating you on the goings-on in the league, and new contract goals, which give the player incentive to avoid being fired. Road to the Show remains largely unchanged, with only the addition of selectable equipment and pre-batting rituals they can perform before heading to the plate, but it's still as solid and immersive as it's ever been, and with year-to-year saves, which allow you to import your data from last year's game, it's still just as fun as it was before. Online mode is still just as hinky as it was last year, with numerous bugs and crashes, but when it really works. So, all you can really do is hope you get a stable game going, and that the game doesn't crash out on you. Diamond Dynasty is probably the only mode to receive any substantial changes, and that's only in the way that they streamlined it to make it feel like other Ultimate Team modes you'd find in other games. It's beginner-friendly, immersive, and the new legends add a nice incentive to keep playing. But some server slowdown and the complete randomness of some of the packs you draw might turn off some players who aren't completely and totally sold on the idea. Overall, though, MLB 15 The Show is still the great game of baseball you've come to expect, and even with some technical hiccups and a lack of too many changes, it's still as fun as it's always been. The improved presentation and faster loading times are sure to please longtime fans, and for those yet to pick up an entry of the show will find one of the most immersive and entertaining baseball sims on the market today. If you're at all interested in baseball, or want to experience one of the better sports games out there today, then be sure to pick up the show. I wholeheartedly recommend it.
So what are your thoughts on the game? Have you had a chance to play it yet? Are you a fan of the MLB? If so, which is your favorite team? Be sure to leave a comment below letting me know what you think, but as always, be sure to like, favorite, subscribe, and share this video with whoever you want. And until then, I'll see you next time.